आई एम प्रीति शर्मा, एन एकेडमिक कंसल्टेंट इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ लाइब्रेरी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस, वर्किंग एट उत्तराखंड ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी हल्द्वानी. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फाउंडेशन ऑफ लाइब्रेरी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस. इट इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ BLIS फर्स्ट पेपर. बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट वॉट लाइब्रेरी स्टैंड्स फॉर. Library is a place where the information is collected, processed, stored, and made them available to the users for an effective use. The word library was used for the first time in the Oxford English Dictionary in the year 1374. Now, what is the philosophy of library science? The library is a nucleus of all social activities, and the philosophy of such institution should be compatible with the ideals of the society, because it has been created for the society and by the society. Now we come to the concept of library science. It is the combination of two words, library and science. The word library came from librarium, which is turned from Latin word liber, means a book, and the French word libra, which also means book or shop of the publisher. Here we want to define what is a book according to Pierce Butler. Generally, books are the social mechanism for preserving the racial memory and the library one social apparatus for transferring this to the consciousness of living individuals. And the science deals with real data and facts. It is the conscious collection of facts, their interpretation by defining and classifying through the logical explanation. The term Bibliothekwissenschaft, which English means library science, was used for the first time in 1808 in the title of German textbook Strittinger, 1829, and the term broadly used in 1928 by the father of library and information science, Dr. S. R. Ranganathan, in his Five Laws of Library Science. The first American school of library science was founded by the Melville Davy at Columbia University in 1887. Now let us move on. What is library and information science? It indicates a combination of two fields, library science and information science. Library science refers to the study of collecting, preserving and cataloging books and other documents in the libraries. And information science, it is the process of storing and retrieving information, especially scientific or technical information. This joint term is associated with schools of library and information science. The first use of this combined term was in the School of Library Science at the University of Pittsburgh, which added information science to its name in 1964. The word library is known from different names in different languages, as in Spanish it's called biblioteca, in German bibliothèque, in Italian biblioteca, in French it's called bibliothèque, and in Russian it's called bibliothèque. There are some definitions related to library science. According to Oxford Dictionary, a library is a building or room containing collections of books, periodicals, and sometimes films and recorded music for using or borrowing by the public or the members of institutions. Another definition, according to the Webster Dictionary, it defines a library is a place in which literary, musical, artistic, or reference materials as a books, manuscripts, recording, or film are kept for the use but not for sale. And one more definition is here. According to the father of library and information science, Dr. S. R. Ranganathan sir, he defines library is a public institution or establishment charged with the care of collection of books and the duty of making them accessible to those who require to use them. Now, what is the need and objectives of libraries? The first and foremost objective of library is to collect, store, and preserve the knowledge for the next generation. To inculcate the reading habits among the society, for research developments, it promotes the self-study among the users, to develop intellectual thinking, it promotes lifelong learning, it saves time as well as money both, it promotes qualitative as well as quantitative learning. Now, let's we move towards the phases of libraries. It is divided into six phases. Here, we will discuss about each and every phases with some details. First one is oral or verbal learning. It's also called human library. In the ancient time, we used to get the information by the subject expert. Religious leaders preached through their preaching by songs, literatures, instructions, etc. Here the subject experts, religious leaders, priests played the role of library. There were some issues as man is mortal, and if any subject expert, religious leader, priest would die, then all the knowledge would also be destroyed along with them. That's why we had to need to store the knowledge. The second phase of temples, churches, and mosque library. This is the type of handwritten library where we store the information on bhojpatras, tamrapatras, leather sheets, afterwards cloths and resumes cloths too came into light and could be placed in the temples, churches, mosques, etc. And Brahmi and Kharoshthi is the ancient name for writing system of ancient India. Whereas Brahmi script was the earliest writing system. And Sanyuktagam was the first book which was written on the Bhojpatras. The next and the third phase is conventional library. After the invention of printing press by the Portuguese in 1556, it is like a new era for library. Now we can print many copies in very less time and able to disseminate the huge information. For example, books, maps, charts, newspaper, etc. Now the fourth one is electronic library. In electronic library, we used to get information through the electronic devices like TV, radio, DVDs, etc. in form of text, sound, graphics, and motion videos. For example, Rishi Darshan and Gyanvani is a type of program on radio, and Tarang and many more educational channels had been broadcasted on television. Now we come to an advanced phase of electronic library. It's called digital library. It is a collection of documents in organized form available on the internet, and it helps in compacting the size of library and to get an easy access. For example, ebooks, magazines, articles, research papers, etc. And the last but not least phase is the virtual library. It can be said the library without wall means there is no staff, no buildings, and no any physical material. It is a cloud-based learning where all the information is curated on cloud. And there is no time bound, and we have an access to knowledge anytime from anywhere and to anything. Now we move on to evaluation of library. It is distributed into three time period. First one is libraries in ancient time, in medieval time, and in modern time. We start from libraries of ancient India. In the Vedic age, instruction and knowledge were imparted orally without the medium of books. Here we can see that the person who had the expert in a particular field had distributed knowledge through verbally. It's like a moving library, and the person who gains the knowledge can be said they are the users. In the archaeological excavation at Takshila, though it was the famous seat of learning from 700 BC to 300 AD, with the advent of Buddhism, teaching came to be practiced through the written word, and this in turn gave rise to the libraries. Fayyam noticed such libraries at the Jetwana monastery, as situated in Travasti in UP, the Nalanda University in Bihar. It had a huge library complex known as a Dharmganj. It has three void buildings. First one is Rat Sagar, second one is Ratnodhi, and last one is Ratnaranjak. This library was destroyed by the Muslim iconoclast Bakhtiar Khilji in the year of 1205. Libraries in medieval India. In medieval India is known for book lovers of Mughal emperors as Akbar, Babur, Humayun, Firoz Shah Tughlaq, Alauddin Khilji, who found the Imperial Library, at present known as a National Library of India. Most of the emperors had their personal library and also established many madrasa and libraries. Amir Khusro is also a book lover and appointed as the librarian of Jalaluddin Khilji for his royal library. He also designated him by Mehfil-e-Quran. The Mughal Emperor Humayun died after a sudden fall from the stairs of his library in his fort at Delhi in 1556 AD. Now, in the last, libraries in modern India. The college libraries are the pioneer of a modern university library. Sir Warren Hastings, the Governor General, founded a madrasa at Calcutta in 1781. Duncan emphasized the need of the library for the collection and preservation of our ancient valuable learning and tradition. At the year of 1811, Sir Lord Minto, the Governor General, was also mentioned in his minutes that library is attached to each of the college under the charge of learned natives with the small establishment of servants for the care of manuscripts. Perhaps this is the first statement regarding libraries in the academic setup in India. afterwards Sir Lord Auckland, the Governor General of India, further outlined the library policy in his minutes. He makes the greatest use of the libraries, which are now attached to many of our institutions. Thus, we can say that the collection of libraries has started growing in the modern India, and in the year of 1882, some of them having the good collections. Now, we want to describe which library is the oldest library of the world. Ashurbanipal is the oldest library of the world. This is the world's oldest known library, found in the 7th century BC for the royal contemplation of the Assyrian ruler Ashurbanipal. It's located in Nineveh, now in Iraq. It has a trove of some 30,000 cuneiform tablets organized according to the subject matter. The first library of India. The National Library of India, found by Alauddin Khilji, situated in Belvedere State, Kolkata, in West Bengal. It was established in 1836. At that time, it is known as a Calcutta Public Library. On the 30th January 1903, it was famous as a public library. And the 1st February 1953, it was declared as a National Library of India, the first state central library of India. The State Central Library, Kerala, is one of the oldest libraries in India. It was established in the year 1829 AD. The library was then known as a Trivandrum Public Library. Thank you.